already discussed, various instruments are used in clinical laboratory and their working is based on a very varied sophisticated techniques. Okay, so measurement of liquid works different compared to measurement of solids. Not only that, for other things also, maybe you need something to maintain the temperature. Okay, it works on a heat controlling technique. So different instruments work on different techniques within the laboratory. So for accurate testing of samples and accurate results requires use of good instruments. So what is the meaning here? The good instrument means a well-maintained, accurate instrument that gives us no room for error. So there is no errors happening while preparation of the reagents and the solutions required in the pre-analytical phase. So now the balance is used to find out the mass of a substance by comparing it with the known mass. So at this point, we come towards a scientific definition of a balance. Okay. So here we compare the mass of the substances that we need to measure with the known mass. So if it is equal, then we have the accurate mass of a substance. So there are three types of balances that are commonly used in the laboratory. Number one, physical balances. I'm sure you have studied this in your plus two. There's a two-pan analytical balance. Same thing, I think you have seen this in your chemistry. The first physical balance, you might have observed it in physics. So in chemistry, you might have seen two-pan analytical balance where you load the substance to be weighed and then change the solid weights to see equal movement of the pointer on both sides of the beam. So if it's moving equally, then it is in balance. Now, more commonly, see, the thing with the physical and analytical balances is it takes long period to work. Okay, it takes long time to do the weighing. So you need an instrument that it can give faster results quicker so that the pre-analytical phase time is reduced. So for that, you have a mono-pan balance where only one pan is there where you keep the substance to be weighed. Okay, let us start with physical balances. We'll go over it very briefly. So it's an open two-pan type of balance. This is used for weighing out substances where great accuracy is not required. So we come to one of the drawbacks of physical balances. Well, this using the physical balance, the accurate measurements of the substances, accurate weighing of the substances is not 100%. Okay. So that is why we use physical balances where we don't have to accurately weigh a substance. So that is the one drawback of this type of a balance. Second, it is used to measure the mass of the object. So these are useful for preparation of qualitative reagents. Okay, so qualitative reagents are the reagents where we are just checking the presence or absence of a substance. We are not going into what is the exact concentration of the analyte. If it is present or absent is the thing with qualitative measurements. For this, we actually don't use lots of accuracy while preparing the reagents. So let me give an example for you. All of you have done Hess test. Analytical balance is where we are focusing our, we'll go in a little bit more detail. So it's a class of balance designed to measure small masses in sub milligram range. So here at this point, with the use of analytical balance, we are trying to increase the accuracy of our measurement. Okay, so when we look at the physical balance, it is more into limited range of gram, but when we go into analytical balance, it gives us the advantage of measuring the substances in sub milligram range, even less than milligram we can go. So that is the advantage of any analytical balance. So physically, we'll see what are the components. It has a beam okay, on top of which the agate plate will be balanced. This is very important. So this will give us the point of pivot at this area where agate knife will be present. So equal distribution of weight will be there on either side. So based on the comparison of weight in each pans, the movement of either it will go down or go up. If the weight is equal, it will remain equal, and that is indicated by a beam. Okay, we'll see that. There are stirrups, there are scale pans on top of which we place the substances to be weighed and also the known solid weights. There is a pointer. Now this pointer is very important. It will tell us if the balance is, if the weight is balanced or not. If it is moving more towards the left side, that means the left side substances are heavier than the solid weights. If the pointer moves more towards the weight pan side, then we have to reduce the weight. So a pointer will be very useful in telling if the scale is balanced or not. Then there is an ivory scale. There are rigid supports so that it can, the whole setup of these pans can be maintained without any external interference. Wooden platform is there with leveling screws to make sure the platform itself is very flat, and we have a handle. Okay. And all of this is situated on a central vertical pillar to ensure again the balance. So what is the weighing procedure? First, adjust the leveling screws to make the pillar vertical. Okay, the leveling screws will be present at the bottom of the wooden platform. So now this is to ensure that the gravity is not working on any one side. Okay, if it is slightly slant, one side of the balance might be taking more weight. Okay, to avoid that, we have to make sure the whole thing is level. Now next, release the beam by turning the handle. To turn the handle, it releases the beam. The pointer will swing onto both sides. Okay. So if the pointer is not moving equal distances on both left and right, that means the balance is not balanced. Okay, the weight is, the scale is not balanced. So it will take some more adjustments. You have to adjust it again using the screw nuts at the bottom. Okay. Place the object to be weighed in the left pan. Always use the object or use the left pan to place your substance to be weighed, and on the right, use standard weights. Okay, adjust the weights from the weight box, solid weights, that's the point, so that the pointer will move equally onto both sides. Okay, as I said before, if it moves more towards the left, that means the weight, this object to be weighed is heavier than the solid weight. We might have to increase the weight on the right side of the pan. If it moves, if the pointer moves towards more towards the right, then the solid weight is more, we have to reduce. Now, whenever we are checking for the accuracy of any weighing, so we keep the weights constant. So let us say when we are weighing a 10 milligram of something, okay, we will keep the weight constant on the right, and we increase or decrease the quantity of the object depending upon how far the pointer is moving on either side. So care and maintenance, the beam should be arrested when not in use so that it should not move, and also you cannot add weights if the beam is moving. The weight should be allowed to lie in the pan and must be placed in a box when not in use. Please don't misplace it. Balance should not be loaded with weight greater than the maximum limit. So each balance has a maximum limit. Above that, the accuracy of your weighing will get affected. Okay. Let's say a balance has a weighing of 10 grams. Okay. Capacity of 10 grams. If you go on trying to weigh substances or objects that are more than 10 grams, the accuracy will get affected, and at the end, you might not get an accurate weighing. The substance should not be weighed hot. Again, that is very important, because at hot and cool, the changes in temperature can have an effect on the movement of beans, and it will give us an inaccurate measurement. The cabinet should be closed before weighing so that there is no external interference by air. Okay, so these things you already studied. This point is more important. The use of monopan balance. Okay, so this is the type of balance we routinely use, because it gives us a very important advantage. One thing is the high accuracy in the sub milligram range. Okay, we can go up to picogram also. Okay, it is because this being an electronic device, the weights are changed by an electromagnetic setup. We'll see that. So it gives us the advantage of going very low in terms of weight and also in terms of time. The weighing of this is very easy. You place it, it immediately reads and gives us the weight of the substance. We might have to change based on the accuracy of our measurement. But so this reduces the time required for preparation of weighing of substances to prepare reagents. So that gives us two high, very good advantages of using monopan balance over our analytical balances. What is the number one? Number one is the time required is lesser, because you place it, it will give you the reading immediately. Second is because of using electromagnetic system for as your balancing rate, it gives us the advantage of going into very low weighing ranges, that is sometimes even lower than picograms. Right, so these are electronically operated, we know. They work on the principle of substitution of weights. So we'll see the substitution method of weighing may be used. So in this substitution method, counterpoise weights are added to one pan to balance the unknown load on the other. Okay, little complicated to understand. Counterpoise weights are added to one pan to balance the unknown load that is present. When we see the mechanism, we'll come to know. Then when weights are substituted for known weights are substituted for unknown load. Okay, you keep on adding till the weight get the scale gets balanced. So this is how it works. You see a fulcrum on which a beam is located. That beam is connected to the pan where the item to be measured is placed. On the other end of the beam, there is a coil and a magnet, an electromagnet, which will increase or decrease the counterpoise weight based on the current that is passing. Okay, so what determines the passing of the current? The weight on the pan. When that is in equal, so the amount of current generated here and applied in this also, if it is, it becomes equal, then we see the fulcrum to be level, and that gives us the reading. Okay, so what are the components? There is a beam, there is a central knife edge or a fulcrum on which that beam is balanced. A pan is present on which we measure the item to be measured. There is a stirrups, series of calibrated weights are present. Okay, on the other side, a fixed constant counter weight is also present. So how does it work? So beam on a single pan balance is situated asymmetrically on the central knife edge. The lengths of the lever arms are not equal. So one side is shorter than the other side. So there is an existing imbalance. Okay. So the pan is supported by a stirrup placed on the outer knife edge. So both knife edges are on the same plane. So a series of calibrated weights are supported from the same end of the beam from which the pan is suspended. So there is a calibrated weight that is already present on the end of the pan. A fixed constant counterweight is present on the opposite end of the beam. which gives the balance in equilibrium. Okay, so this, all these mechanisms make sure that beam is in equal moment. It is in equilibrium. It's not going to move. So when you place an unknown weight or an object to be weighed on the pan, this disturbs the equilibrium that is present. So beam deflects to the direction of heavier side. So when you place an unknown weight, it is going to deflect towards the heavier side, that is the pan. The electronic system will try to return the whole setup back to equilibrium. Okay, so how do we do it? It removes the calibrated weights which corresponds to the mass of the unknown object that you are trying to weigh. It will remove that much weight, so to make sure the beam is returning back to the equilibrium. So the removed weights will give you the weight of the unknown substance. Okay, so that is the weighing. So this principle of weighing is called as weighing by substitution. So let us just see this once more. So first of all, the beam is situated asymmetrically. Okay, there is already a lack of equilibrium. So the length of the lever arms of left and right are not equal. On one end of the lever arm, that is there is a pan situated and that is supported by a stirrups. So both knife edges are in the same plane. It is completely horizontal. A series of calibrated weights are supported from the end of the beam where the pan is suspended. Okay, so there is a series of calibrated weights which are already known. So now this asymmetric balance and the series of calibrated weights make sure that beam is completely parallel. Okay, so now when you place an object to be weighed, so this creates the disturbance in equilibrium. So the beam that is straight will move towards the lighter side. So if the substance you are going to weigh is heavier, so the beam will go down on that side. Now, so based on how much weight is present, that many calibrated weights are removed, okay, to make sure the system comes back to equilibrium. So this method of weighing is called as weighing by substitution.